yoking the teams. I was informed that Mr. Cunningham was missing. He had left the party early in the day, and it was evident that he had gone astray. I felt less anxiety on the subject, little doubting he would gain the cab. I had the pain to learn on reaching the cab that Mr. Cunningham was still absent. We at length encamped near a pond. But poor Mr. Cunningham, poor Mr. Cunningham came not. After an almost sleepless night, I rose early and could only relieve my anxiety by organizing a search. I set up a small stick with a piece of paper fixed to it containing a word. Dear Mr. Cunningham, my horse's tracks will lead you back to the cab. And I learned that the two men sent back had at length found Mr. Cunningham's track into the country I had twice traversed. They came to where his horse lay dead. Had he killed the horse rather than the dog? Had we pursued our course down the bogan, his life would have been saved. They traced a continuation of his track, where many natives had been in camp. They found a portion of coat. I could only hope that Mr. Cunningham might still be brought back to us. And thus, for the first time, I learned that poor Cunningham had really been murdered by the savages. I could discover, raised a small mound of